Joining me on the broadcast at this point is Mr. Annadurai. He's, of course, a very well-known Indian scientist. He's a vice president for the Tamil Nadu State Council for Science and Technology at this point. Appreciate you speaking with us. The lander is, of course, on course, sir. Share with us, what is the next step as far as the lander is concerned? What is its role on the lunar surface, once that landing has, in fact, taken place?
Vikram, the last 15 minutes of its powered descent to the lunar surface is supposed to be a very, very tenuous thing, because it has undergone a rigorous test what's supposed to be done there. So it will take its course to softly land on the designated place on the moon, such that its belly, breaking on the six-wheeled rover what is kept, it should be safe enough. Such that when it is safe and secure, such that when it lands, it's not getting any shocks, and it's able to come out without any issue, so that the subsequent 14 days, the Prajñan works in tandem with the lander, and over and above that, the instruments kept on the lander, Vikram, also intact, able to deploy for the lunar quakes to identify anything, and the lunar dust getting levitations, the phenomenon to study, and enabling the communication between the Earth and the Prajñan, mm-hmm. as well as after landing, showing, yes, I have landed. So that way, the Vikram, which is on the way to the moon, the last 15 minutes, September 7th, early morning, the 15 minutes is going to be a nail-biting moment for the entire the Indian community.
Right. Now, with the second maneuver that was successfully completed on Wednesday, Vikram will be heading to the moon. Tell us something about, the approach velocity. What is, the current speed? How is this speed reduced for the lander?
Yeah, now if you look at here, the way in which the lander is moving, it's orbiting around the Earth, orbiting around the moon now with a 30 kilometer closer and somewhere around 95 to 100 kilometer at the higher apogee point, apogeean point of view. But when the descent activity is initiated, autonomously it's supposed to go. By the time it's expected some the speeds, a few times of an aeroplane, whatever flies, which nominally 600 to 700 kilometers per hour it flies. But this is expected to fly for the couple of thousand kilometers per hour. That is the speed it goes. But finally, when it lands in a designated place, after 15 minutes of the controlled descent using the 5 800 Newton throttleable engines. So like a pilot is, when the aeroplane is coming, he is decelerating the system using the jets, and that when the landing on landing gear, when it lands on the aircraft landing system, it goes and finally it silently it settles. But now here it is much more than that. The speed is high, but still when it comes there, speed has become almost zero, somewhere 100 meter above that. Then trying to see with 800 Newton thruster, just it will try to balance, yeah, lift it there, and the camera is trying to look to the surface and ensure the surface is giving a very, very safe landing point of view. There is no big boulders, a crater, some type of thing is not there. So that it will be able to land there. Then it will softly land. Now, if it is not, then I think probably laterally it has the capability to move and the land in a safe place. So the last 15 minutes, the 800 Newton 5 thrusters, which is throttleable, that means it can vary thrust from all the way from 800 Newton individual thrusters down the line, somewhere around 300 Newton level it can go down, but in tandem with other thrusters, sometimes 2 will fire, sometimes 5 will fire, so all the combinations will be happening, and the deceleration profile is already fed to the onboard computer.
Okay.
So it will decelerate as expected, and the cameras will keep looking at whether it is going in a designated path. So it is going in a closed loop form, autonomous mode. So all these 15 minutes, it is keep decelerating and as per the expected profile, and as well as it sees the places where it goes east as expected. If not there, minor corrections also it can do. In the landing site also it can do. So that way, I think all the actuators, the sensors, onboard computer, algorithm, all are in place, tested many times, and the final test to make it to happen, it's going to happen the last 15 minutes of the
right
controlled landing. What's going to happen?
So you know, you've been the project director of Chandrayaan 1. What are the kind of details that the lander is supposed to collect from the lunar surface?
Yeah. Vikram, after landing, immediately it should, after the few minutes or an hour or so, it will try to switch on its camera and try to see its environment, whether the dust has settled down. Because though many actions have done, dust to come very far, but still when it's landing gear, when it lands, it's expected some dust can come off. So that dust is settled, for that it's be seen to that. It will enable the lander or Prajñan to come out using the Vainar deployment. Then the command goes to the Prajñan to automatically go down, and this will be also monitored by the cameras, that landing, how it landing, how it's coming down. So then it goes around the lunar surface as far as Prajñan is concerned. So lander plays a major role to have the communication between the Prajñan and the Earth, two-way communication. The commands also from ground it can go, and similarly whatever Prajñan takes, the data also comes. The lander plays a major role of relay communication. Beyond that, it has its own systems. That systems basically ensuring, yes, first telling safely I've landed. Beyond safe landing, in situ analysis point of view, it will try to see what is any possibility of lunar quakes, like earthquake we are talking about there. There is expected mild but high frequency quakes, shaking is being talked about there. Whether what is nature during the 14 days of stay, try to see. And another thing is the less dust is coming because of levitation, not because of wind, because of the electrostatic charges coming and that lifting the system up. Dust coming up is being talked about, so that will try to quantify in the landing site what's happened there. And similarly, the thermal profile that the landed place, what is the thermal profile during the 14 days happened, it will be able to probe through that. So like that, it is lander Vikram. One side it is enabling the safe landing, second side enabling the safe deployment of the Prajñan, then enabling the two-way communication between the Prajñan and the Earth, and beyond that, its own science instruments enable that system happen there. So collect all the data and try to give back to the Earth, both the science and technology data's point of view.
All right, that's a very comprehensive breakdown of what the lander is really expected to do. But you know, just to shift our focus from the micro to the macro pictures, this is of course a rare feat in the history of space missions, and clearly it has silenced the critics. How do you see the magnitude of this achievement, and what is it going to do for our place in the world?
Yeah, the achievement is basically, look at here, instead of trying to reply the critics, it's basically, it's our legacy, what we gained from Chandrayaan 1 and beyond that, even the Mangalyaan also. That means we have our own path and we have gone that path to succeed. So that way, it's our need, whatever we have taken, the target, we have done it. So, and second thing is, from the legacy of Chandrayaan 1, we have gathered the place to be landed going to be here because of abundance of resources the South Pole is called for. So now when we land, I think we are going to be the first nation to make any soft landing on the moon. So that way, I think we ourselves set our own targets better than what happened previous occasion. So yes, we have an orbiter around the moon, orbiter around the Mars. Now a landing system is going to happen on the moon. So that way we are setting our own goals there. So subsequently also we look for from here next target. For example, the moon is point of view, is it softly landed now, and 14 days we are going to be there. If everything is successful, then next mission in terms of Chandrayaan 3, 1 and 2 we have done, 3 should be a logically, after soft landing, come back safely back to Earth, possibly an unmanned system. But whereas Mars is concerned, what is happening in like our Chandrayaan 1, Chandrayaan 2, Mangalyaan 1 to Mangalyaan 2 can be a lander on the Mars. Like that, one at a time. Then probably expect when the Indian also going to the space, near space is going to happen around 2022-23 point of view. So when everything is happened, so then possibly if really required, man has to go to the moon and Indian has to go to the moon, I think India also will be ready for the time frame. So that way we are, India is setting its own goal over the what it gathers from the previous step. So that way, I think we are quite satisfied with what we have done all along, and what we are setting goals is matching with the logically extending what we are doing all previously.
All right, logical extension to what the achievements of Chandrayaan 1 were all about. But after Chandrayaan, moving on beyond Chandrayaan 2 as well, we're headed now for Gaganyaan. Your views, sir, on India's manned mission into space?
Yeah, this is another logical extension. Say, look at here in the sphere of space, and now you look at here, almost all spheres we have touched. Our transportation system in terms of PSLV, GSLV, Mark 1, 2, 3, we have done it. And we have all the missions in terms of remote sensing, communication, navigation, meteorological, the science missions, very many things like AstroSat, that we have done there. So then beyond Earth going, we are talking about Chandrayaan 1 we have done for an orbiting mission around the moon. And we made our remarkable discovery of water on the moon with the first mission itself. Similarly, Mangalyaan, with a modest launch vehicle, we are able to go to the Mars in the first attempt, and a good number of discoveries, science point of view, has come out from Mars also. Now Chandrayaan 2 is softly landing on the moon. So these are all the facets, almost like any other spacefaring nation, first two, three nations, whatever they have, I think we got it. But one thing is remaining, that means safely putting a man onto the space and coming back. Actually, we have done safely putting the many space probes and brought back safely also done, but everything is unmanned. So man has to go. Yes, some couple of Indians have gone to the space and come, but not from Indian soil. So if we acquire the capability of putting Indians from Indian soil to go to outer space and come back, so that will make a complete fulfillment of all the aspect of a modern space journey. Either in terms of launch vehicle or in terms of the family of the spacecrafts and the landers and rovers, I think we have done everything. So just man putting on the space is missing. I think that also you are able to fill in the gap. I think we have the whole gamut of space program we have mastered. So that way Gaganyaan will fill that gap.
For more such videos, subscribe to the NewsX YouTube channel, hit the bell icon.